Hi everybody, welcome back. Today we're going to search multiple PDF files at once using regular expressions. So the whole purpose of this is to go through a folder, pull out a number of PDF files, bring them into a data frame, and then search for particular values in those dot text based on some regular expressions. So the problem we're facing is you have a folder, or it could be stored anywhere. As you can see here on the screen, you have a number of PDF files. So what we want to do is bring those PDF files into our program, format them in such a way, and then bring them into a data frame. And once they're in the data frame, they basically will then be searched based on some regular expressions that we've created. So let's hop over to the code and see what it's all about. Okay, so what we have here is our basic import statements. So what we're using here today is pdfminer 3, pandas, and some numpy. All right, so we're going to use those as part of this program to work on the data and make the data give us what we want back. All right, so as you can see here, I've got them here in front of me. We move down through the code then, first thing we want to do is actually set the program up to process a PDF. So PDFs are a little bit trickier when you're bringing data in from them because they're basically image files pretty much in the background. So when you bring them in, you actually want to do is create them as text. Once you have them as text, then you'll be able to actually work on that text through the Python data frames and everything that comes with it. Okay, so these first four lines are essentially from the PDF miner here, and essentially they're setting up how to process the PDF. Okay, so there's a number of things here. You have a text converter, you have a page interpreter, have a string as well, a file handler, and that's used to manage each file as you loop through it and extract the data from each file. Okay, so I've set up a function here. Let's just kind of walk down through the function. The function purpose of it is obviously to open up the PDF files, read through them, extract the data, and then further on down in the code, it will give you your output. So if we go down here, this is what we're kind of expecting to see. Let me just back out a bit. So you have some output here. There's two ways to look at it as well. You've got some output here. We're going to do it in two ways. First of all, we're going to look at the data based on some text we actually dictate that we would like to search the data frame based on particular columns. Or the other way we're going to do it is we're actually going to use a regular expression. The regular expression is here. And in there we can change, I'll do that during the program, we can change parts of that just to test the program and to test what we're looking for, and we'll give you an idea and show you actually how this all comes together. But let's, before we get to that point, let's go back all the way up to the top and go through some of the code. So I've got a number four and if statements here. So this first line here, what it's doing is essentially we're looking to look at the path extension, which is this. As you'll notice, this is just brings us to the folder where all the PDFs were stored. So that just basically brings us to this folder here. Okay. And then what it does is what we're going to do is in that path and the path extension, we're going to check the folder and look for the extension of the file. So this base line here is basically saying look for every file in this folder that has an extension of .pdf. So what it will essentially do is it ignore these folders. There's image files or image files here. That's the video and recording. And we'll ignore this JPEG as well and PNG and this Python file. So essentially what it's doing is looking for to see any of these Adobe Acrobat files here. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, there's about 6 of them. Okay. That's the first step. And then when it's open, it is basically these lines that these are doing is they're essentially scanning each file, extracting basically the data contained within them. That's all those lines are down. So actually from this line down here, down to here. they're scanning the each page and then extracting the data. So that essentially now, at this point, what it enables us to have is all the data that's in each file. We're able to go then take that data and process. So let's move on. Okay, so this basically text found line is essentially now creating a variable. And what it's doing is it's giving us the data that's in each file. So now we have it in this text format, we'll be able to start actually working on the data and format it and get into where we would like. So these next lines is an element of formatting. So this is basically bringing in all the data found in text found, but it's basically splitting it to a line by line basis. And then there's a couple of bit of formatting we wanted to do. Now this mightn't be specific to everyone who's looking at this and looking to implement this code, but it's something I had to do. Essentially, I had to do a bit of cleaning and cleansing on the data. So there was things around spaces and empty values that were appearing. And then there was, in some instances, there was some empty kind of lists, because there's a list within a list contained. So I had to clear them out. So this is clearing out. This line here is cleaning out the list. This line here, so if I just go in here a little bit further, let's make sure you can see this. And this is clearing out the empty spaces. This is clearing out the empty list. Okay. So now what we have at this point is we've run through the PDF, we've extracted all the data in the folder, we've run through each PDF, extracted all the data out of it. We've done a bit of cleansing on it, and then we have it prepped and ready to move on and bring it into a data frame. So the first thing I want to do is I know in this scenario that all the files, if I go back here and show you this, just show you an example. So let's just say take CV1, right? They are in a certain format, they are line by line in the PDF, and I know there's 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 6 lines. So in this scenario, I'm able to pre-format the code to basically know that there's 6 lines in the actual file. So if you have a PDF or you're using this code and you know it's in a certain pre-format, this will help you to use that code to go through each file, because it's in a pre-format, pull out the data pretty quickly and easily. So I just wanted to show you that so you can understand what that is. So this in this other, if I go close this, sorry, and if I go back here, okay. What this line is based on is saying that there is in the list there at each point there's 6 pieces of data per line. So at each point per line, after the 6th point, you're basically saying the next start of the next row that will go into the data frame is 6 in length. Next row, 6 in length, 6 in length, 6 in length. Okay, so that allows us then to create, when you'll see further on, 6 rows in the data frame. And we will then basically able to search that data frame for pieces of information we're looking for, either through regular suppression or through the specific pieces of data we're looking for. Take you through that in a second. So basically, again, this is basically taking the iteration and slicing it based on the split length here. Okay, and it's creating a list called output items. All right. So once we have at this point all the data split out based on the split length here, so we should have 6 rows. We just need to iterate it through one more time to put it into a final data frame and basically concat it, which basically means it brings it all back together and it's in a format that would show on a data frame. Okay, so I'm just going to go back out of here. So let's go back out. So at this point, I run this code, okay, all down to this point. And it's basically giving us all this here, all right? So what you have now is you have the 6 PDF files that I showed you in the folder here. They've been brought in, they've been cleansed, and they've been put onto a data frame, all right? So to get to the main area of this video is what we're trying to achieve is we're searching through multiple PDFs and looking for information that's contained in that PDF that we can use. So in this example, we're just given, we've created dummy PDFs, which are of nobody or anybody I know. But say you were in a recruitment industry and you said that you had a particular job trying to fill, what actually characteristics do these, do the people who have submitted their PDF have in these files? And can we filter on that and find them quickly so that we can then actually see are they suitable for a job? So the search criteria here, there's two ways to do this. So I'm going to take you through the first one. So we're basically doing a search criteria here. The first option you can do is you can search specific columns. Okay. So I know through creation of the data frame that I have created language and specialities as a column in the data frame. And the reason I'm picking those two columns is I'm looking for a particular piece of skill that candidate might have. So they could have Python, HTML, they could have Perl, do deep learning, machine learning, natural language processing, whatever. What we're going to do in this first instance is we're specifying, well, actual fact, see can we find anybody, any of the candidates have this particular skill set. So this line here is basically an expression to go and loop through the data frame and bring us back anything that has these search criteria. So in this example, I've basically said it's either can be ABC, Perl, or ABC. So let me change that to DEF, right? Do this now. Okay, so we're going to change it to DEF just to make it different, but it shouldn't make a difference. All right. So what this is basically doing is say, go look for ABC, Perl, or DEF, and says, can you find it anywhere? Yes or no. Okay. In this instance, it said, well, hold on. There's a Perl here. So we could see up here on this candidate, Patrick Doe. He has a language, he said, as Perl, as one of the languages he has. So he said, well, actually, we're looking for somebody with Perl. We contact this candidate, Patrick Doe. So the actual code up here, what it's doing is it's looking at this whole data frame, but it's only returning back the line that has Perl in it. In this instance, Perl is the only instance that appears on the whole data frame on any row. So that's why all 0 to 4 here are actually not returning back below. So in this instance, what the regular expression has done is it searched the whole data frame, looked in language and specialities specifically, and says, oh, does this person have Perl? Yes, they do. It brings back one line, line 5, and says, Patrick Doe, a candidate has Perl. You should be contacting your recruitment agent. Okay. So if I was to change that to SQL, okay. So in this instance now, what we've done is we've said, we're looking for somebody, candidate who has SQL, all right? So if we go back up to the original, we can see on all these lines, right, that all the SQL appears here, it appears here. Now, it appears there and it appears there. So it appears on 4 lines. So the regular expression, what it's doing is it's looping through the data frame again, but it's specifically again looking in language or specialities, these two here that we specified, and it is finding language, it's finding SQL. So you can see it's there and there. Okay. But if we did something like, if I put in physics, right? The physics is in education, okay? Just bear that in mind for 2 seconds. P-H-Y. Let's just check I spelled that right. That's a capital P, all right? Okay. So if I rerun that again. Now that's come back blank. And that's what we've expected because the regular expression, when this runs, it runs on these two particular columns, okay? And because physics is not contained in language or specialities, it's basically coming back blank. It says, hold on, we don't have anything in here. So if you have something, if you're searching for something specific in two specific columns, you have to add in actually exactly what you're looking for and make sure it's available. Now what I would say is if we want to check education, all right, something we could do here. So all I'm going to do is this Okay. And we want to check education. We're just going to run this again. Now, this particular candidate does appear because we've said physics is in, we've added, told it to include the column education, and we have, and because physics is in education, it's returned this customer. Okay, are you done here? All right, or this candidate, should I say. So there's an example of how you would use regular expressions over a column or columns and specify the text to search for. But what happens if you don't want to do it that way, but you actually want to use a regex, okay? Say you wouldn't be too comfortable, say you're comfortable you creating regular expressions, and some regular expressions can be quite complicated and you want to create them. There's another way of doing this, I'm just going to go through it now, and it actually uses regular expressions. So I'm just going to do this, okay? And what I'm going to do is just uncomment these two here, and I'm going to, oh, I think I know what the problem is here now. Give me 1 second. And yeah, sorry. So the reason that's coming up as a mistake here, that's a small thing. The actual, I had the pattern commented out, which is this. So this is the actual pattern. So if I run this now, okay. And if we do, oh yes, one last thing, sorry. Oh, the joys of commenting out. There we go. All right. So what we're doing here now, or as in the above, what we're doing is we're looking for specific values which we had typed in. Here, what we're going to do is we've created a regular expression. Now, what this piece of code is going to do is actually going to search through the whole data frame. So we actually don't even have to define up here. What we defined is the particular columns. Now, in theory, we could have typed in all the columns up here and basically then put in our criteria here. But if you have a data frame with more than 20, 30, which can happen, columns, it's a lot of typing, a bit of work to maintain. It could be a bit cumbersome when you're trying to do other things. What this second option does is you don't have to type in the column names. It just searches the data frame, every column, and then basically, based on the pattern that you put in, does the search criteria. So a couple of things I want to run through with you on this one, okay? So we know it's going to search through the whole criteria. There's something down here which you might be wondering what this is, okay? So there's two outputs of this before we kind of go into the code. The first is there is, obviously this is the original main, which is fine, data frame, which is fine, which is going to be searched. But when this actually does the search, it basically searches using a combination of these, okay? So as you can see, we have one, ABC is the first search pattern, Perl is the second, and ABC is the third. Now I'll change those in a minute, we'll just mess around with them just to show the output. But basically you're going to have for this pattern a combination of these three. Now see here, that sign symbol there, not symbol there, that's basically it's an OR in the pattern. So we're searching for this or this or this. But in this search criteria here, what it's actually doing is it's searching for one or all or a combination. So where, if you go down here for a second, we do have 0 to 5 rows, but we do have 7 searches it's doing. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, yeah, 7 searches. And based because it's 7 searches there, it's a combination of this. So it's either going to search for all three on their own, a combination of any of these three, okay, or all three together. All right, so we had those 1, 3, 3, 6, 7. And that's basically what the output of this table is doing, is it's basically giving you back the Boolean, whether there was true or false based on the values entered. It's nothing really for you to do to use this, but I just wanted to add it in so she can understand what's going on here. All right. So our criteria is ABC, either ABC, Perl, and ABC. So what I'll actually do is I'm going to change that last ABC to an SQL, okay? So before I changed that, that was ABC. It brought back one row, Perl, which is this row here. But again, what it did was it searched over every column in the data frame. So by what I'm going to do here is by adding an SQL now, I would expect that we have more than one. So let's just have a look at this. Okay, perfect. So what has happened here is it's basically looked at Perl or SQL. ABC is not there, so it's just going to ignore it. But basically, it's looked at Perl or SQL for Perl or SQL or both. They could be on the same line. So we do know from our previous, the first example of the pattern searching, SQL is there. So again, SQL appears 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And as you can see, SQL appears here and here, but it only appears here. But that's what the actual code is, what I was referring to above, is it's allowing for the fact that it could be one, all three, so it could be a combination of any three, it could be one on the three, and all three on their own, okay? Combination of any three or all three together, okay? And that's what that's doing. It's allowing for the fact that SQL could appear in more than one column, okay? So again, that just does that. So if I was to change, this, we go back up here, we go, let's just do ABC, let's do that to ABC. So again, the pattern searches come back all false in this table, and that is correct because, again, what we're looking for is either one combination three or altogether three, but ABC doesn't appear anywhere here on any of these as a string and anywhere that it would bring back the result. So that's why that would appear as false and that this data frame appears empty. So if we just go here, let's just try this, let's go PHP. So I know PHP, so let's just look at this. PHP is here, I'll just make sure I haven't missed it. Oh yeah, it's there as well, and it's there. So I expect to bring it back three rows here, one, two, this one, this row here, two, three, actually bring back four. So there you go, there's four, brings back four rows. And again, this table takes you through where it's true, false, and what it's all about. So that is a way of searching, bringing in multiple PDF files, searching through them, bringing them into a data frame, getting the data correct, and then running a regular expression and a pattern search to try and find them quickly, any data you're looking for, quickly and easy. And it's much quicker than actually running over PDF files individually and on their own. So I hope you liked that today. I hope it's got some benefit. Big appreciation if you could subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button, you'll get alerted when we're actually putting up the next video. I'll obviously be posting this up on YouTube, probably sharing it through social media. I've now started putting the actual code using these videos. I use Pastebin, so I'll put a link to that in the description in the field, and I'll also put in some timestamps as well for different parts of the video so that you can see if you want to skip certain parts to see how I did things. So thanks for coming along again. Really appreciate you being here with Data Analytics Ireland. We have another video coming soon. Hope you're all keeping well and stay safe. And thanks again. Bye.